Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Right, well this is going to be the hopefully final part to my AMT longslide build, the one that was used in Terminator. Now then, in the last video I had shown you how to make the slide and so forth. Well, in this video we've now finished the slide. It's all been sprayed along with the frame. This has just been sprayed with silver car spray paint. It's been undercoated previous to that with white undercoat. I prefer white because it brings the luster out in the silver a bit better. So let's just take it all apart so you can see it. There's the frame. As you can see, I haven't done down in there. This was all blocked off. So none of the spray paint went down in there. It doesn't matter about this section, but this section I'll try and keep as clean as possible. So that's the frame all done. So I'll put that to one side. Now then, the slide, as you can see, well hopefully you can see, has all been finished. The cutout for the ejection port has been done and filled. All of the side pieces have been filled. And it's come up pretty good. It's not brilliant, but it's come up pretty good, not bad at all. It's better than my original one, especially around this area here. The original one, I wasn't sure on sizes, and as you can see, this has got a gap down in between the rear sight and the edge piece, and it's too thin, whereas this one is a lot better, as you can see. It's a lot thicker, a lot stronger, so it should hold up a bit better. Right, okay, so that's enough of that one. Now then, the spray coat was just done with light coats of spray paint, so that goes for the undercoat as well. Now the only inside sections of the slide that I had that I sprayed silver intentionally were this area, because you can see it when the gun is out of battery, so it needs to be silver on that side. This side I didn't worry about too much, because you can't really see it that much. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, so they were the only areas on the inside of the slide that I sprayed silver. The end of the muzzle doesn't really matter because the barrel bushing will be over there and obviously the guide rod plug. Now then, the front sight depends on the age that the pistol is going to be. The one that was used in Terminator, the front sight was silver. The later version AMT long slides that were built, the front sight was black. I think this was because of reflectivity problems that they had with the first batch. You can't see your front sight when your rear sight's up. You can't see it in bright light. It reflects. So I should imagine that's why they've done those in black on the later versions. But if you want the one from the film, then it's got to be silver, because that's what that one was. As you can see, the top of the slide rib is serrated, as it should be. I showed you how to do that in the previous video. Now, I slightly overdid the curvature there. As you can see, I went in too deep. Doesn't really matter, doesn't detract from it too much, but yeah, I went in a little bit too deep there. So, you know, be a bit careful when you are filing this area out. So that's pretty much it. Now then, what else have I got to do to this? Well, now that it's all sprayed and dried, excuse me a minute, I was just getting this. Now that it's all sprayed and dried, it was light coats, by the way, built up, as I said previously. Never do it in a full one coat, because it will just look like orange peel. It will just go bubbly, so that's no good. Anyway, coming on to what I want to detail in this video is applying water slide decals, or transfers as us older people know them. Using this, which is gloss varnish, you just cut out your decals. Now I've got some here, here's some I prepared earlier. As you can see, these are the AMT Irwindale California logos or whatever, they're to go on the frame, but it's just to give you an idea. So that's the decals. These are printed myself. A friend of mine a long time ago, when I first did my first AMT, did me some good copies of the transfers, the markings that go on an AMT, and he did a very, very good job. So I've since now printed those out several times onto transfer card or paper on my computer, which is very, very easy to do. And then you've got your water slide transfers. But what you want to do is, using gloss varnish, you need to apply this gloss varnish to any area that's going to have a transfer on it. Now on the slide, the main area is obviously this side, because you've got, just put that down there for a minute, because you've got that on one side, and then on the other side of the slide you've got stainless made in USA. So that square area, or the just over the size of your transfer once it's all trimmed down, you need to paint on there the gloss varnish, just in that area where the transfer is going to go. The same with the frame, you need to paint that area and that area with gloss varnish. Alright, let it dry. This is water-based gloss varnish, so I mean you can use ordinary chemical-based gloss varnish if you wish, but I use water-based, it's just as easy. I think Citadel Paints, and there's lots of other manufacturers that produce this stuff. I use M&P, which is miniature paints. I don't know whether they're still going or not. I've had this years, that's how much of it I use, which is not a lot. But it's water-based, so it's pretty safe stuff to use. So yeah, so you just paint that on there, leave it to dry. Once it's dried, then you cut out your transfers into the sizes corresponding to what you need to put on. So you just cut them around like that. You don't sort of leave it, you can leave a bit around them I suppose, but it's going to show up, it's going to sort of show up, you'll see it. So it's best if you don't, it's best if you cut it to the exact size possible. So that's the do's. Now then, here's one I prepared earlier. Here's one I've had soaking for a while. You just put some lukewarm water in a shallow dish, glass dish, plastic dish, whatever, and then you just soak it in there. As you can see, this is going to be tricky on camera to do this, so I do apologise if I go off camera or, you know, go make it hard to see. But anyway, that one's now pretty much well soaked, so let's take those away. And this is the one that's going to go on our slide. So, what do we do? This is going to be very tricky because I've never done it on camera before. Right, okay. You take the backing paper, you put it onto the area that you know has got the gloss varnish on. Then all you do, and as you can see, it's starting to already come off that backing paper, which is what you want. So then you just grip it, one end, hopefully, with your finger. And then you should, by rights, be able to just slide it straight off that backing paper. There we go. Alright, so your backing paper's off. You can stick that back in the water again. I'm going to move that out of the way before I tip it over. Now then, getting a soft brush, you want to position it to where you know it's going to be needed on the slide. So I'm going to position this pretty much there, which is just about the right spot. Yep, that's about it. That's all level. Then once you've done that, get yourself some folded tissue paper or a nice soft cloth, but preferably one that's quite porous, because you want to soak up the water that's under the transfer. So then you just dab it. You do not brush over it, you just dab it. Alright, so just literally dab it, pushing the water out to the ends or the edges. So you start from the middle and work outwards. Alright, and that is pretty much it. Hopefully you can see, I don't know whether you can actually, but you can just see the edge of the gloss varnish there. It's just sort of there. There's a little bit this end as well. Well, that doesn't matter, because when you spray over the top with satin varnish afterwards, that will then seal up that, and you won't see any more of the gloss varnish. It also seals in that transfer. Alright? So there you are. That's it. That's the transfer attached. It was dead easy. As you can see, there's no sort of, you know, worry about it. You don't have to panic, think, oh my God, it's going to go wrong. Don't worry. Just take your time. It's all in preparation. Let it soak in the water for a good 5 minutes or so. Let it soak for a good period until you start seeing the ends of the transfer start to peel upwards away from the paper, away from the backing paper. So as soon as these ends start to curl up, then that's when it's ready to slide off. Alright, you can leave it in there for a little bit longer, but what you don't want is to leave it in there too long so that it comes off the backing paper entirely and is floating up near the surface of the water. You don't want that. So as soon as it starts to curl up and starts to leave the backing paper, that's when you want to apply it to the model. All right. So there we go. I'm going to do another one, just so you know that it wasn't fixed or whatever. As you can see, well, hopefully you can see. I don't know if you can just about make it out, but there's gloss varnish just there. So this is going to be right from the beginning. So there's our stainless. That's going to be on there like that. So we just drop that in the water. You'll see that they curl up, or at least hopefully you can see on the camera. They do have a tendency to curl up. Don't worry about that. That's just how it is. So you just let it float around in the lukewarm water for a little while. And we'll leave that there. This is where you can talk amongst yourselves for a while. By the way, in order to cut those out, I used a scalpel and a metal ruler. But be careful when using the scalpels. They are deadly things. I would say use a pair of scissors, but I haven't actually got a pair of scissors handy, and I do everything with a scalpel, so that's what I use, being a typical model maker, but there we are. Coming back to the transfers, as I said earlier on, they're pretty easy to produce. Most printers now, the ordinary computer printers or whatever, you can get transfer paper that will work with them, and they're quite good, they're not bad. The secret is, when you're making your own up, is to, if you have got Photoshop or PaintShop Pro or one of those, is to use a transparent background. So that way, when it puts it on the paper, you're not printing out a white background on it. So you must make sure that when you're doing your transfers, you do them on a transparent background when you're doing your program to make them. Otherwise, you will have all sorts of problems. Unless, of course, it's going on a white-bodied car or something like that, then it won't really make much difference. But I always try and do them on a transparent background. All right. Same goes, it's a bit awkward when you've got white transfers to go on a black background, i.e. say you've got like a black frame and you want to put white emblems or markings on there. It can be a bit tricky because then you've got no way of judging what those markings are. It is very awkward. I've yet to master that, to be honest. Maybe you guys know, I don't know. Maybe comment below if you do. But yeah, it can be awkward to print those out, so I try and stick with transfers on a lighter background if I can, which means they can be in black and it shows up better. Anything else I try and just either paint on or, or just get it engraved. But yeah, so this is a cheaper way of doing it this way, but as I say, it can only go on silver or white or light coloured backgrounds. Right, okay, let's see how, after my waffling, let's see how this is doing. Is this coming off yet? No, I don't think it is. No, it isn't quite lifting yet. As I say, it's got to soak for quite a while, so, I mean, if this goes on for too long, then I'll leave it and just leave it there. But anyway, so tools you'll need is gloss varnish, a nice soft brush, doesn't have to be a flat-ended one like this, but just so long as it's nice and soft, just to position the transfer when you're putting it on the kit or whatever, or the slide. A pair of scissors or a scalpel, and a decent pair of tweezers. Now, some of you will prefer flat tweezers, such as these. I personally don't. They get in the way, to be honest. They're a bit too fat, so they have a tendency to just get in the way. I mean, you could file them down a bit, I suppose. I don't know. But I just don't really get on with those. They recommend these a lot in the model making magazines for putting transfers on, because they're flat, they're easy to position the deco and so forth. But no, I don't get on with them. So it's each to their own. Or you can use smaller ones if you so wish. I mean, I've got small ones here. I've got all sorts. But this was raided out of a ex-girlfriend's blooming beauty kit or whatever, I think it was, anyway. I've accumulated a few over the years. I presume she used those for plucking her eyebrows, I don't know. But anyway, so they are handy. But you can buy decent ones, which are stainless steel, like this one, which is very, very good. I've had these years now, but they are very, very good. Look after your tools. The stainless steel ones are better. They won't rust or anything like that. But look after your tools. You look after your tools, they'll look after you. So, yeah, look after them. But, yeah, once you've got them, they might be a bit expensive, but they'll last years. These ones were just coated, chrome-coated ones. They're not stainless steel, at least I don't think they are, but they were slightly cheaper ones. But they're still pretty good. So, yeah. So there we are. So that's the tools you need to put transfers on with. Now then, let's just see. Oh, and of course a dish. Is that coming off, I wonder? Yes, it is. It's just got to the right time. Right, okay. So, get our transfer. Place it on where we want it. Oops. Put it on like so. And then, and hopefully you can see this. I wish I could zoom in a bit more, but hang on. Maybe I can. Hold on. Let's just zoom in. I bet it won't focus, though. Will it focus? No, it's not going to focus. Okay. Manual focus. Let's do it on manual. Then. No, it's not going to do it. No. Sorry guys, it's not going to do it. I did try, but this camera's so crap and cheap that it won't allow me to do it. But there we are. Never mind, it's just how it goes. Anyway, right, what I was going to show you is... I'm going to try and brush that off. That's it, it's coming off. Good. Okay, then you can either grab it with your finger or... Let's do it properly. Let's get the tweezers. Just grab the end with your finger so it doesn't go anywhere. That's it. Now we can position it using the brush. Let's just make sure that is in the exactly the right position, because we don't want it in the wrong spot, which it is. It is in the right position, so that's okay. Let's just move it up a bit now. Like so. There we go. Then we get a tissue paper, again, moving from the centre outwards, we just dab it. Dab, dab. I mean, this technique for putting transfers on, you can use this for doing model kits and anything. It's exactly the same. Always use gloss varnish underneath, because then when you spray it over the top with satin or matte varnish, especially on military vehicles and stuff like that, because they're not gloss, obviously, it helps to seal the transfer in, but make sure you leave it to dry for at least 24 hours beforehand. Alright, because if you get any water trapped under there and you put varnish over the top, it's going to bubble and it will ruin it, and you'll have to start all over again. So, there we are. It's all done. That's the other transfer on that side. And of course we've got our one on that side. So that's done. Now all I've got to do is the frame, which I shall do myself in a minute. So I won't bore you with any more of my waffling. But there we are. It's pretty much done. So that's our slide done. Yeah, and soon that will be another AMT long slide to add to my collection. I may even try and get this one to have the laser sight on it. I don't know yet. We'll see. I don't know. We'll see. It's all dependent on finances and so forth. But there we are. Anyway, thanks guys and girls for watching. Hope you've enjoyed the series of videos that this has shown. I may do one more, just showing it fully complete. I'll see how it goes. But it's whether I can get the parts. I'm after another one of these triggers. I mean, this one was cobbled together and made up myself. It was literally a high capper 5.1 plastic trigger, cut out, reshaped, turned into a banana cutout one, like the original AMT ones were, or the Colt Gold Combat, is it, or whatever they called them, gold cut, and then just a grub screw put in there for the over travel adjustment, which is a dummy one. It doesn't actually work, but I believe that there are manufacturers that do these out there now as aftermarket parts, but it's finding them. They are very, very rare at the moment to get hold of. That and the fact I haven't got a Wilson's or Nova type Wilson's single slide stop there with the extended piece on it. And I haven't got a 4.3 single thumb safety available. Everything else I've got, but not those parts. So, yeah, whether this one will get built, I don't know. We'll just see. It might just go in my spares. Who knows? I might even sell it off. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. And as I say, I'll try and get a video up and going with these parts fitted. But if I don't, then this will be the final video for this series. Hope you've enjoyed them, and it's given you an insight into how to make a long slide pistol 1911. It can be used for any long slide. You don't have to just go with the AMT ones. As I said, you don't need the top rib on there. You can always do away with that and just join the front end to a standard slide. and do everything to it like a normal 1911. You don't have to have this on there. This was only put on there for the AMT. So yeah, so you can use these series of videos for whatever suits your purpose, really. Anyway, chaps and guys and girls, thanks for watching. And this is LaZouche Custom saying stay sharp, but stay safe. And bye for now.